We have learned that combustion is very important. So let us try to find out what percentage of air supports combustion using the burning candle experiment. Set up the apparatus as shown in this figure here. A candle, a floater, and sodium hydroxide solution. Light up the candle and cover it with a boiling tube as shown here, part B. After some time, the candle goes off and the water level in the boiling tube rises. So, what happened? Candle burns for a while, then it goes off because it uses up the active part of air in the fixed amount enclosed in the boiling tube. This in turn leaves a partial vacuum in the boiling tube. The greater atmospheric pressure acting on the surface of the sodium hydroxide forces the solution up into the boiling tube. Since the water in the boiling tube has risen to a certain level, then it is possible for us to estimate the percentage of air that was used up in the burning of the candle. What we need to do is to measure the level of water before and the level of water after the experiment. So suppose the level of water before the experiment is level P centimeters and after is Q centimeters. The expression for the calculation of the percentage of air is given as follows. P minus Q over P times 100 is equal to the percentage of oxygen in air. Now suppose P is 20 centimeters while Q is 15.8 centimeters. The percentage of oxygen used up by the burning candle is calculated as follows. 20, which is P, minus Q, which is 15.8, over 20 times 100, giving us 21%. This is a very accurate figure. Just like we had already mentioned that oxygen is 21% of air. That means the active part of air that has been used up for burning is oxygen. Although we got a very accurate figure of 21%, sometimes we may not get the exact value. This may be due to experimental errors. These errors may result from sodium hydroxide solution may not absorb all the carbon 4 oxide gas. Another one may go. The candle may go off before all the oxygen is used up due to the buildup of carbon 4 oxide levels. In this experiment, sodium hydroxide solution is preferred because it absorbs excess carbon 4 oxide that is produced during the combustion. Although water could also be used in place of sodium hydroxide. Also, before taking the measurements in the lab, you will need to wait until the apparatus cooled, because heating causes expansion of the gases in the apparatus. Another experiment that could be used to measure the percentage of air that supports combustion is heating copper. Now, this setup will help us understand what we mean. We set up the apparatus as shown, whereby we have two syringes of equal volume. In this diagram, the syringes are 100 cubic centimeters syringes. Then we'll connect the syringes to a combustion tube. Make sure that we have airtight junctions. Inside the combustion tube, we have copper tannings, which initially are brown in color. To start off the experiment, you light up the Bunsen burner and start heating the copper tannings. At the same time, as shown in this diagram, you start pushing the syringe piston back and forth. So you'll push this syringe so that all the air in this syringe here goes to this syringe here. And then you push this one back so that all the air goes through again. The copper tannings will start to react with the oxygen in the air as it moves from one syringe to another. At the end of the experiment, all the copper reacts with the active part of air, which now we know is oxygen, to form black copper 2 oxide. An observation at the syringes, which were initially at 100 cubic centimeters of gas, now read 79 cubic centimeters of gas. From this, we can be able to calculate the percentage of oxygen in air. Therefore, this we take 100 cubic centimeters, subtract 79 cubic centimeters, we get 21 cubic centimeters, divided by the initial volume, which is 100 cubic centimeters, and multiply by 100, we get 21%. Another accurate value. However, sometimes you may not be able to get the accurate values. Some of the experimental errors include: there is a possibility that the air might leak from the setup. And again, not all the oxygen that is in the syringes may be used up during the reaction. And finally, the air that was initially present in the tube, the combustion tube, is not accounted for. In this setup, we usually add glass walls in between the syringe and the combustion tube to stop copper tannins from being sucked into the syringes. And the air is also passed repeatedly and very slowly to ensure that a larger percentage of air reacts with copper.